shining on those. And we are back to Tanya Meme, who's going to show us how to make these beautiful memory lights. And this is what they look like.
Yes.
Take a look at that.
And so we have detailed.
A there we are. Okay, and these are called memory lights, and they're for the dark. And you said this was inspired by your daughter, Ava?
Well, you know, my daughter is now 2.5 years old, and she's now a little bit afraid of the dark, and she wants a nightlight, but the nightlight we have is too bright. So I thought, what can I do that's kind of fun? So I took some photos from some trips that we'd been on. Then every night we would tell stories about, remember this, remember that, and I would make one of these, and I have these by her bed.
We have a photo, you have a picture of them at night.
Yes, at night. I want to show you what they look like when they're all lit up.
Oh,
look at that.
That's wonderful. And these, like a little country.
Yes, and these are non-flammable, obviously, because they're the little fake tea lights. They're battery operated,
right.
So you don't have to worry about that. And she can leave them on all night, too.
You don't have to blow them out. Special paper? What are we talking here?
It's regular photocopy paper. I actually bought some photo paper that has a little bit of a sheen. But to be honest with you, you can just use regular paper. You can use a high-gloss photo paper, whatever you want.
Oh, wow. Let's show everybody, though, what these little tea lights look like, in case you're wondering. And they just turn on automatically. Yeah?
Super easy.
There they go. Like that. And you could get these at Michael's.
It's hard to see in this.
Yeah, some are brighter than others, but you can get them at any craft store or Michael's.
All right, so what do we need to get started?
Okay, so what you need is obviously some photos, and I decided to use some from actual real vacations. This is a shot that I had taken from Germany, for example. I found that architectural photos or landscapes, like right here we have this is another castle, but right here I have, I went on a train into the Rocky Mountains, all the way across the Rocky Mountains, and this was taken while I was on the train. Wow. So you want some fun family photos like that, maybe take some trips, and then...
Why do you suggest, though, that you do architectural buildings rather than...
Well, you can see right here when you cut it all out, which I'm going to show you how to do that, it gets very intricate and really cool, and you want to have windows and different things so that when they illuminate, the light just shines through and they kind of even twinkle at night. It's really, really beautiful. You want some tea lights here, the battery operated ones, some tape, a little hole punch is great. On some of them I used a hole punch to create little starry nights.
Sure.
If you're gonna do an evening scene. And then you have your X-Acto knife, which I love this. I use this for so many different things. So first thing you wanna do is cut off the border. Obviously you can see that there's a white border. So you're gonna wanna cut it all off, trim it right here. So this one is trimmed up and ready to go. And then I'm gonna show you how to do some X-Acto knifing, some cutting.
Okay
so this is this one is what it looks like when it's finished. Okay, we can do like a little, you see,
you really got in there and got this detail.
But it's gotta be very cathartic too, when you just sit there to focus on it and cut out those little things.
Well, I enjoy it. I enjoy it. It might look painstaking, but it's really not.
I was gonna say, there's a lot you're carving out there. Do you suggest you do that? I
mean,
you recommend that?
I would, because you know what? Look at the glow that it gives when you see when you see the photo in the before. Like, it just, the light really shines through the window. So that's kind of the effect you want. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that you get a photo, test it like this. Take it, wrap it around, and make sure that the edges match.
Now, why do you do that?
Okay, so that it looks amazing when you cut the sky part off of it, so that it's not all crooked and that it fits really well around your cylinder.
So it's like wallpaper, like we did the other day with
when you put
The end starts where the start.
The end starts with the start, and if not, you gotta have to fudge it a little bit.
I just made that up. That's a T-shirt right there.
I like it though.
The end starts where the beginning.
It works.
You amaze me every day, Mark.
Isn't it amazing?
Yeah,
absolutely.
You know.
So okay.
I think I'm done.
So what you want to do is you want to start right at the one side and just go along the edges of the building. Okay.
And that's very detailed.
It is very detailed, but it's actually really easy when you're using an X-Acto knife. Okay.
Well, if you didn't want to be so detailed, could you use a non-X-Acto knife?
I probably would not. Would not.
Not so exact.
And you don't have to do all the details. Okay, so just go like that.
You're now moving pretty quickly.
Moving pretty quick. Yeah. And here's a fun little tip for the windows. So to do it really super fast, just draw a line, 1, 2, right here, all the way across.
Uh-huh.
Okay. They don't have to be perfect. Then you flip it over and see where the marks are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You just cross them off and make little squares and then punch them out.
Oh, so you can really see the,
Right? And it really didn't take me that long. And when you punch them out, you want to punch them out this way.
Punch it to the back.
To the back, so that in case it rips a little bit, you rip the back.
hanging chest.
There you go.
Okay.
That's cute.
And so even though it's not perfect, it actually looks
so
really cool.
So what do we do from here?
Okay, so then from here,
we
have it all carved. Now this is how easy it is. That's why I love this, it's so simple. And this is where the magic begins, darlings. Mm. So you just wrap it around, mm-hmm. Piece of tape. Right
now,
here.
Are you looking as you do that? Am I looking to find something that goes past the height of my candle, or do I want to?
You definitely want something that goes past the height of the glass.
Okay.
Could you glue gun this or glue it because it's paper?
I mean, yeah, you could, but it's easy with tape. And sometimes I was going to say if it gets hot, but it's not going to be getting hot because you're not using a real candle.
No, you could use
it. So you could glue gun it, but it's easier this way. And if your kids want to help you, you're not.
Right.
Sometimes a glue gun can be a little dangerous. And then you pop in the little tea light.
Look at that.
And there you go.
Oh, it's so cute.
Ava, when she saw these, because I had them I made them in the kitchen, she looks up at them and I had them all lit. And she goes, wow, those are so cool, Mom.
Show the one with you and Ava in bed. That is so cute. I love that.
Yeah, so this is just something that I created. It's not one of the castles.
Precious.
But this is one of my favorite photos of me and Ava sleeping. And what I did is I made the top like a little starry night, and I can show you what it looks like lit up, too.
That's great. And it doesn't have to be like a perfect photo. I love that it has sort of a wash over it.
It's beautiful. That's right. That's so nice. If you would like step-by-step direction for Tanya's crafts, they're available on our website at hallmarkchannel.com/home and family. Up next, Jesse Jane's got a bling tip for you for your purse when we come.
Nobody's supposed to know I snore.